We would like to welcome all of you who are visiting our parish today for our Easter celebration. We'd also like to let you know that we live stream all of our masses. So if there's anybody that is sick or homebound that couldn't make it to this celebration with us this morning, they can tune into our social media and watch it on the live stream via Facebook. And all the information for finding those masses on Facebook is in our bulletin. As a courtesy and with respect for others, please turn off all cell phones and electronic devices. The rectory office will be closed on Monday and will reopen on Tuesday, April 23rd at 9:30 in the morning. If you have not done so yet, please return your rice bowls by next Sunday. We kindly ask you to take home a copy of our weekly bulletin, which contains all upcoming events and an Easter message from Bishop John Bears. Once again, I would like to invite any children that would like to help us with a special song. It's going to take place after our communion hymn. I will make a quick announcement, so all the kids who want a Easter chocolate can come up and help us play this fun song. Just do so as quickly as possible. Our opening hymn this morning is going to be number 61, Jesus Christ is Risen Today, number 61. Our celebrant this morning is Father John, who is assisted by Deacon Peter. Please stand.
Lord Jesus, you are the resurrection and the life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the Paschal Lamb sacrificed for us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are true love poured out from the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. On this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, may through the renewal wrought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
Our first reading this morning is a reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Found the entrance antiphon so expressive of the meaning of Easter for us. It just said, I have risen and I am still with you. Alleluia. This year, for me, my sister Teresa, or Terry, is the Mary Magdalene in my life. Mary, as you know, was at the tomb when Jesus died and was really the first disciple to announce the resurrection to the apostles. this altar of surrender is very much a reminder of what St. Ignatius of Loyola, the founder of the Jesuit Fathers, in his spiritual exercises, he tells the retreatants to, in making major decisions, try to picture yourself on your own deathbed. And in picturing yourself on your own deathbed, it will really make a total difference the way you actually see things before you. So today I would just ask you to, in the Mass, picture yourself on your own deathbed and ask yourself, you know, what kind of a person do I want to surrender to God in the manner of His Son, with the grace of His Son in each of us? T, my sister Teresa, or as her grandchildren and children called her, Titi, in her life, as I looked at it, she really was an example to me of trying to squeeze everything out of every day, every moment that she had. They lived in Scranton, Pennsylvania, and she would go out to the migrant fields and bring food and sandwiches to the migrants that were working in the fields around Scranton. When Bishop Romero was assassinated in El Salvador, Teresa went out of her way to get the movie Romero into the local theaters in Scranton so that the children could go and see the impact of this tremendous bishop's life on the people of Salvador. And she was a member of Al-Anon for 41 years and at the age of 70, she ran a 5K three times a week. She kayaked up in the mountains and the lakes around Scranton. She was a member of the drumming group, a group of people who would get together weekly and just play drums for a spiritual experience and for healing for people in the world. She was a member of the choir. And in her three-year bout with cancer, the last year, she spent 3 days a week on dialysis and one day a week on chemotherapy. So 4 days a week on machines. But this girl squeezed every ounce of energy that she could out of life. And I remember my sister Marianne and I spent 40 days with her as she was dying. I remember her going out as one of the local buses would pick her up at the house and take her to dialysis. And just watching her get on the bus, and all I could think of was, this is what she did with the little kids that she had four kids, she had seven grandchildren. Watching, as you have watched your kids get on buses and go to school. And at the end of her life, she's getting on a bus and going to save her life with the dialysis. During that experience, she took her grandchildren to see the movie Mary Poppins. She took them twice. She divided the kids up. And then when Marianne and myself, my other sister, we went to spend our time with her, she said, I want to take you to the why we're here today. We're here because we are so blessed to live in the risen Christ at every moment of our lives. That's why I asked you to give each other a hug when we started the Mass, because the risen Christ is in each of us, and we're called to experience that in our own lives. The secret, as I understand it in the spiritual life, is to surrender. To surrender to God's mercy and God's love all the days of our life. And this altar is a reminder of that surrender that He taught us, and He showed us how to do it. And the beauty of your presence here today with us celebrating is that every day for us is an experience in the risen Christ, and to seize it and to live it and to enjoy it. And last summer, our family had a family reunion in Pennsylvania, and we rented a larger house so that everyone could stay for the weekend. And it was really a very wonderful experience. What T wanted to do was, she got up at 4 o'clock in the morning, went to dialysis, came back so that she would be at breakfast with all of her children and her grandchildren and my sister and myself. And in the course of the day, she says to me, "John, you want to play horseshoes?" And the next thing I know, she said, "How about badminton?" So we went and played badminton. And then she saw a hammock on the trees. She went and swung in the hammock. And then she took her kids for a little walk up the hills and overlooking some of the lakes that were there. It was an experience that we'll never really forget. But in the morning on Sunday, I invited them all to the kitchen table for Mass. And what was so powerful for me was to look at my nieces and nephews, and believe me, my nieces and nephews have really struggled with life. They've had many, many difficult problems. T was there for all of them. And as we sat at the kitchen table, I looked out at the kids, and I said to them, "Wow, you have arrived at such maturity in your life. Your lives are so together now. And they're together because you learned through your mother's example, through your father's example, to surrender, surrender to the love of God that's available every day." And I just want to say to all of you kids as you're sitting around, you're challenging me. Your life, you have surrendered your life to God's mercy and love. And you're saying to Uncle John, "Uncle John, have you surrendered? You do a lot of preaching. Have you surrendered your life to God's hands?" And that breakfast table is what we're here for this morning. Mary Magdalene was at the tomb, and this altar is a tomb reminding us that He has risen, He is glorified, He's praying for you and I to have the courage every day of our life to surrender. And the question for me, and the question perhaps for all of us, am I ready? Just stand and renew our baptismal vows. My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with Him in newness of life. And so, Now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Church. And I have questions for all of you this morning, and I have questions for myself. Do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death, was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? I'm going to now, Deacon Peter, bless you with holy water, and it's a way of going under the water. What's so beautiful about the Feast of Easter is that you and I are capable of breathing under water because of his death and his resurrection. So as we get sprinkled with the holy water, just realize that we're all capable of breathing underwater because the risen Christ has overcome all the darkness that was in that sea by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Why don't you be seated for the breakfast meal? Risen Christ, there are many petitions in the hearts of this assembly this morning. Please hear our prayers as they rise to you.
Our response is, praise your glory, O Christ, for the Church, as it heralds the gospel of life throughout the world. May Pope Francis, Bishop Barris, and all the clergy be renewed in their mission to help others who are seeking God. And may the Spirit of Christ prepare every heart to receive the good news, we pray.
Praise your glory, O Christ.
For new members to our faith, and for those who receive into full communion in the Catholic Church, may their sharing in the banquet of the Lamb be a rich source of grace and peace, we pray.
Praise your glory, O Christ.
For all the baptized, may our participation in Christ's Paschal mystery strengthen our unity and inspire us to live more reverently, we pray.
Praise your glory, O Christ.
For all who are away from home this Easter, especially missionaries and members of the military, may God sustain them and keep them safe from harm, we pray.
Praise your glory, O Christ.
For those who are still far away from the peace of the risen Christ, may the Spirit stir in the hearts of enemies a desire for harmony and friendship.
Praise the Lord,
for those who have died in the joyful hope of eternal life, may they be found rejoicing in the reign of heaven, especially Donald Norton, Dennis Driscoll, Richard Warner, and for all those who are remembered in our Easter floral novena, we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace. your sacrifice and mine may be found acceptable to God, the Father of all men. Accept, we ask, Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the paschal mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, Lord. But on this day, above all days, to laud you gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death. By rising, he restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Taking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with John, our Bishop, with all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Invite the risen Christ to join you in communion
in the spiritual communion this morning. My brothers and sisters, receive the risen Christ in the spiritual communion. Amen.
Amen.
No, what's louder? My brothers and sisters, behold the risen Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who fall to his supper. Lord,
Thank you.
bind your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us bow down our heads and pray for God's blessing. May the extraordinary ministers bringing communion to the sick provide the consolation needed on this very Easter day from the risen Christ. May the blessing of God be with all of you. May the blessing of God over all of us descend in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace to spread the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And I believe there are holy water bottles in the back of the church if you leave or at the doors. Please take some holy water home with you for this Easter. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Love and serve the Lord. Amen. And there also are flyers if you'd like to put them in the window of your home that Father Larry is making available, reminding people that we are members of the risen Christ.
Please join us in our recessional hymn number 167. Alleluia, Alleluia, number 167.